As you know, the Secretary, along with Secretary Geithner, have completed the strategic and economic dialogue with China. And you've also heard from both secretaries during their press avail at the end of the program. During the course of the S&ED, as we call it, the Secretary announced expanded exchanges, increased cooperation on energy and education, on energy, looking for ways to continue to diversify global energy supplies. She also indicated that we had frank and detailed discussions with China regarding the situations with respect to Korea and Iran. The Secretary indicated that the Chinese government and the United States government share our concerns about gravity of the situation. We share our hopes for stability and peace in the region, and this is a shared responsibility of both countries, and we will closely cooperate in the coming days and weeks. And on Iran, she indicated that there is a clear path forward, and our strategy involves dual tracks, and we continue our efforts on both sides of that. And she clearly indicated that there were deficiencies, as she called it, in terms of the joint declaration and that was worked out in Tehran last weekend. I'll come back to that, I'm sure, with your questions. We can confirm that the two U.S. citizens that were kidnapped in Yemen by a tribal group have been released. We have not seen them at this point, but our indications are they've been turned over to a mediator. We are in touch with the one of the American citizens by text message, and they've indicated that they are safe. Staying in the Middle East for a second, we deplore the murder of Member of Parliament Bashar Mohammed Hamid Akhaidi in Mosul yesterday. The Iraqi people have shown repeatedly that they will not be intimidated by violence as they work to build their democracy. We understand that Iraqi authorities have arrested two suspects. We hope that those responsible for this crime are swiftly brought to justice. We extend our condolences to the family and colleagues of the victim. And today, as well as yesterday, Deputy Secretary Jim Steinberg and Assistant Secretary Jeff Feltman had another follow-on meeting today with Prime Minister Hariri as we continue our close consultation with the Prime Minister and the Lebanese government on the way forward with the peace process and building a stable and prosperous Middle East. Undersecretary Bill Burns met today with Foreign Minister Rasool in Afghanistan to build on the progress achieved during the successful visit by President Karzai and his cabinet to Washington. He also met with Ambassador Carl Eikenberry and U.S. Embassy and ISAF staff.
Give us a sense of the type, nature of discussions you had with the Chinese during the S&E dialogue. Number one on Afghanistan, Pakistan, secondly on Burma, and finally on Tibet.
Well, during the course of the S&ED, there were sessions on regional issues. China has influence with respect to Burma. It is, as Kirk Campbell said before, leaving for the region. It is an area of significant concern to us, both in terms of Burma's relationship with its own population, but also the Burma's activity, which has broader concerns. We have concerns about Burma's cooperation with North Korea, for example. So I haven't had a detailed readout of those sessions, but we again share common interests with China, and in some cases they can have influences with certain actors in the region that are more significant than ours.
On Afghanistan, Pakistan?
That's another example of where if we see progress in the region from a security standpoint, that clearly benefits everyone, including China.
And was Tibet discussed specifically?
It's hard for me, from halfway around the world to describe everything that we discussed this week.
Sure. Iraq.
Of course.
Though in his interview with the Washington Post, the Prime Minister of Iraq, Nouri al-Maliki, was quite annoyed at Mr. Feltman's suggestion that they ought to have, that he and Alawi should have Plan B. And he says that the political process is moving fine, we're moving according to our own table. Could you explain to us what is Plan B as seen by the
State
Department?
Sure it's what, I'm not sure. I mean, it's up to Iraq to develop a Plan A, Plan B, Plan C.
But Mr. Feltman did say you must have.
Let's start with the what we seek is the formation of a new government in Iraq. We'd like to see that government emerge as quickly as possible. We're very encouraged by the fact that, notwithstanding it has taking some time, to accomplish this, and notwithstanding that there are episodes where Al-Qaeda and other elements have tried to use violence to restart sectarian violence, and we're very encouraged by the fact that the actions of the government and most importantly the actions of the Iraqi people are focused forward rather than backward. We want to see, on behalf of the Iraqi people, the emergence of an effective government, an inclusive government that reflects the will of the Iraqi people. Clearly, you had a very close election, there are two major blocks, and these blocks have to work together and see how to form a credible government that will work on behalf of all of the Iraqi people. As Jeff Feltman and Chris Hill and others have said, it is in Iraq's interest to see this process go forward rapidly, credibly, transparently, and that's all we seek.
Thank